Hi, I'm Ollie Hooper, a quantitative developer at QuantConnect, and this is Idea Streams, a weekly video series where we test an idea derived from current market trends by building a trading strategy on QuantConnect. In this week's Idea Streams, we're going to be looking at an article that I found in the Financial Times about unprofitable tech companies, and in particular, a certain chart, which I find quite interesting. So let's have a look at that article now. We can see that the title of this is Nuts, Where Are the Profits? And this is the chart that I am referring to. So we can see this is non-profitable technology companies. This is a Goldman Sachs constructed index. And we can see since about late 2014, we can see how it's performed pretty flat. And then after the coronavirus crisis, it's shot up almost 400%. So what we're going to be doing in this video is we're going to be trying to replicate this index and see if we get similar results to the Goldman Sachs index. So let's hop into our algorithm lab. And the first thing that we're going to do is we're going to look at how we're going to create our universe. So we can get rid of that. And let's head into the documentation. So go to algorithm reference and then universes. And because we want to find unprofitable companies, then we're going to be using a fundamental universe selection. So I've gone down to fundamental selections and we'll just take this here. Copy and paste that in. And there we have our two fundamental selection filters, the two functions. So in this first function, this course function, we're going to be getting data such as the prices or the volume of the traded stock. So we're going to do a quick filter on that, making sure that we only get big companies and not penny stocks. We're going to do a dollar volume filter on that. So we're going to return c dot symbol for c in course if c dot dollar volume is greater than, let's say, 10 million. Great, so then after it gets filtered through this course filter, it then goes through this fine selection filter. And this is where we're going to be discovering if the company is a technology company and if it's unprofitable or not. So let's go into the documentation again, and this time we're going to be looking at the reference tables for the fundamental data. So let's go down to asset classification, and you can see we've already got this example here for our technology companies, where we're making sure that the asset classification, the Morningstar sector code, is the same as the Morningstar sector code for technology. So we can just copy and paste this in. Great, and let's call this tech. There we go. So now we need to look and try and find a data point that we can use to evaluate the profitability. So let's go into here. I'm going to control F and search up normalized income. Okay, so we're going to take this data point here, the normalized income data point. Let's take that. And so we're going to say unprofitable equals x for x in tech. So we've already filtered through the tech here. X for x in tech if x dot financial statements dot income statement dot normalized income is less than or equal to zero. Okay, so this is going to filter through and see whether the company is profitable or not in the latest data point. Okay, so next we want to sort our companies because we don't know how many companies we're actually going to have in this fine selection function after we've sorted for tech companies and then unprofitable companies. So we want to find a way of sorting them so that we can get the top 50 in a certain area. So we'll take the top 50 in terms of total revenue. So let's call this sorted revenue. It's going to equal sorted on unprofitable. And the key we're going to use, we're going to create a lambda function here, and lambda f, f dot, I'm going to use their total revenue. So we can just copy and paste this, and instead change it for total revenue. And we're going to make this descending, so reverse equals true. Great, so now we've got a list. This sorted revenue is a list which has been sorted by the total revenue of unprofitable tech companies. So that's exactly what we want. So now we just need to return our actual universe, And we're going to take the top 50 of these companies. So return F dot symbol for F in sorted revenue and the top 50. There we go. Great, so we've done the main bulk of the algorithm here actually. All we need to do now is just create a, what we're going to do is create an equally weighted portfolio. And the way we're going to do that is just down here in on data, we're going to do a monthly rebalancing. So let's have a self.month variable to keep track of the month. And we're going to say if self.month equals self.time.month, then we don't want to do anything, as this means that we've already rebalanced in that period. Self.month to be the current month. So that's just a quick, easy way of doing monthly rebalancing. Then we're going to get our securities in our universe that got let through. So that's just going to be data.keys. And we want to get the number of securities so that we can equally weight this portfolio. So n securities equals len securities. Great, now all we need to do is just loop through these securities. So for s in securities, then we're going to set the holdings of this security to 1 divided by the number of securities to equally weight it. Perfect, so this should be working all fine. So let's have a look at the chart again and let's have a look at when it started. Okay, so we can see it started on the 10th of September in 2014. So let's put the 10th of September in. Oh, that's October. There you go. And let's set this to run and see what results we get. Okay, so we can see that the algorithm has finished running and it looks very promising. It looks like we've managed to replicate the same results of the Goldman Sachs Non-Profitable Technology Companies Index pretty accurately. So if we just compare this chart, I mean, it's very obvious to see the big uptick after coronavirus crisis, and they're matching pretty similarly. And if we look at some of these movements in the portfolios, they look to be matching the movements of the Goldman Sachs index as well. So overall, it looks like we've managed to replicate this index fairly accurately using a monthly rebalancing of the top 50 by total revenue stocks, equally weighted of unprofitable technology stocks. Great, so with all that in mind, I hope you now have a better idea of how to approach creating portfolios that are monthly rebalanced based on certain fundamental data points, such as whether they're tech companies or not, and whether they're profitable or not. If you'd like clarification on any of these points or have any general questions, please do not hesitate to reach out. Both the team here at QuantConnect, as well as the whole Quant community, are valuable resources. Until next time, happy coding.